The uMobile Maven archetype provides a quick and easy way to create a new portlet-based uMobile module. Projects created using this template contain separate tablet and smartphone views for view, edit, and help screens, as well as contain sample code for using the JSR286 portlet API. To create a new project, we use the Maven archetype generate command, enter a group name and project name, then accept the rest of the provided defaults. Once the archetype command has completed, we have a fully functional Maven-based mobile portlet project. To build the new project, simply navigate into the New Project folder and run the Maven package command. Next, navigate into the uMobile server codebase and run the ant deploy portlet app command to deploy the new portlet into the uMobile server. Once the new portlet has been deployed, we must register it in the uMobile server's database. To create a new portlet registration, log in as an administrator and click on Manage Portlets in the Admin Tools tab. Select Register New Portlet. Then select our new test portlet from the list of deployed portlets. Create a display name, key name, and description for the portlet. The next step allows us to set custom preferences and display options, which we'll ignore for now. Next, we assign the portlet to a category, then add it to the Everyone group so that all users can access it. In the last step, we'll mark our new portlet as published. This step can be configured to provide delegated workflow capabilities, as well as automatically publish and expire content on the configured dates and times. Finally, we get a chance to review our new registration, correct any mistakes, and save. Our new portlet is now fully published and permissioned to be accessed by all users, but it is not yet a part of the default layout for any of our users. To add the portlet to a fragment or collection of role-based content, we return to the Admin Tools page, then select Fragment Administration. Here, we'll add our new content to the Academics fragment, which is distributed by default to all student and faculty users. We can use the server's content gallery to locate our new portlet and add it to the fragment. The new layout is saved automatically, and changes will be pushed to all student and faculty users upon their next login. To demonstrate our new content, we'll load the web-based mobile interface from an iPhone simulator. Since I haven't yet authenticated, I get the guest view and am not yet able to see the academics content. Once I log in as the test student user, however, I have access to additional content, including our new test portlet. Clicking on the portlet allows us to see some default content demonstrating pulling user attributes such as name and email address from the portlet API, as well as view the placeholder help and edit screens. For more information about U-Mobile and U-Mobile development, please visit jasig.org/umobile.